Good morning, guys. So I'm in West Belfast in a Catholic neighborhood, and this is a Protestant neighborhood. And you know, the police, they will regularly close these gates to keep the communities apart when there's heightened sectarian tensions. And actually, this was the scene as recently as just April that saw some of the worst rioting in the past couple of years here. And it really just goes to show that here in Northern Ireland, the sectarian tensions, the violence, they're not just in the past. They're very much in the present. In Belfast, you can still hear the drums of war, rumblings from the distant past. This march marks the Protestant victory over Catholics in 1690, a sectarian battle they've been fighting ever since. Now tensions between Catholics and Protestants are rising again here thanks to Brexit, Britain's vote to leave the European Union. It drew a customs border in the Irish Sea between Northern Ireland and Great Britain, angering Protestants who see themselves as more British than Irish. That sea border is being cheered on by an American president who wears his Irish Catholic American heritage on his sleeve.
If you're lucky enough to be Irish.
My mother's father's name was Finnegan.
I'm Irish.
Anyone wearing orange is not welcome in.
That last comment made in 2015, when Biden was still vice president, was a joke. But to orange-clad unionists, it wasn't funny. Joe Biden, what do you think of him?
Interesting character. Sadly, the vast majority of unionists would see him as almost a hate figure because of his remarks that Orange aren't welcome here. We are the Orange Unionist people.
Mervyn Gibson heads the Orange Order, which organizes these marches.
Does he really want to be seen as someone supporting terrorism? I don't think he does, and I don't think he supports it. But the IRA here murdered people, murdered innocent people.
That was during the Troubles, when Catholics and Protestants fought each other in the streets for three decades.
This is from a terror attack.
Yes, in a pub, 1976. Now, how do you think I feel? You know what I mean? I lost friends in that pub. So, I mean, let's get this right. No, people can watch from afar and think they know it. They know nothing.
But it depends on who you ask. Catholics, who support the Republic of Ireland, known here as Republicans, see Biden as an ally and an Irishman through and through.
Joe Biden's great-great-grandfather, I think it's Owen Finnegan, left from that port there on a coffin ship for America. His family homestead's over there where that church spire is over there.
Darren Cunningham farms oysters that he exports to the European Union. He's a Catholic nationalist for sure, but he also says the border deal is just good for business.
When you hear Joe Biden talking about how Irish he is,
yeah,
quoting Irish poets, what do you think? Do you believe that?
I just love Joe Biden. I think he's brilliant. He's just been so good for Ireland. It's fantastic. It's like all our Christmases came at once.
But Northern Ireland can seem like a zero-sum game. What's good for one side is seen as catastrophic for the other. These days, the sectarianism is symbolic, like the massive bonfires Protestants burn every year. The loyalists who built this woodpile in Larne outside Belfast say it's Northern Ireland's largest. On top, symbols of Irish republicanism. They say they don't want war, but they're ready for it.
Well, I'm hoping that it doesn't return, but if it does return, well then, we're ready to pick up the gun and...
It's already been happening. Protestant loyalists staged street riots earlier this year, reacting in part to the Brexit trade deal.
Northern Ireland right now is like a big pile of tinder, and all it would take is one spark to set it off.
It's a particularly sensitive moment. 2021 is the 100th anniversary of Northern Ireland's founding. This place was forged in flames, and many here worry that with Brexit and Joe Biden, Belfast could burn once again.